Warrakerna is in the middle of nowhere. Kalgoorlie, 1,100 kilometres to the southwest. Alice Springs, 800 kilometres to the east. And out here, the laws delivered differently.
Farron, were you going to go down and play football or what?
Yeah.
Did you want to lift?
Come with us. Well, jump in, mate. Jump in.
Senior Sergeant Revis Ryder and Acting Sergeant Wendy Kelly were put in charge of Western Australia's only all-Indigenous police station. In a week of turmoil over the killing of George Floyd in Minneapolis and uproar over the arrest of an Indigenous teenager in Sydney, Wendy's is a voice of moderation.
Police need to get out there, not with their guns and things. Just get out and say to the mob, you know, let's talk about what's going on, you know. I think the communication and engagement is a key to all our policing.
Wendy joined the police force more than 20 years ago, but as a young adult, she was hardly a model citizen and alcohol was largely to blame.
I lived on the streets in Perth for years.
How was that?
Oh, that was scary. That was scary and it was rough. I remember those days. And I remember trying to crouch in a little corner and it was trying to get warm.
So what turned your life around, Wendy?
One night I ended up with my throat cut and the doctor that I went to see had said, Wendy, you're so lucky. He said, you're only centimetres away from your jugular. I was in a detox unit with the Salvation Army and it was like I woke up the next day and I looked and I thought, no, I've got to stop. I've got to stop. So I did.
These things always take baby steps. So what were the first steps that you took?
I did rehabilitation for 3 months and then I started working in the detox unit where I started.
So you wanted to use your own experience to help others?
Oh, absolutely, and I still do it. I still do. I've never forgotten where I've come from, which is my key.
And you must use that every day in the work that you do now.
Yes, because every time I see someone, it's like, that was me. I can see me. Hiya.
At Warrakerna, Wendy and Revis worked to build a bridge with the local community and it's paid off handsomely.
The social issues dropped considerably. The crime dropped considerably. The kids all going back to school and, you know, they're just so excited to see us. And it was great.
High five. Oh, solid.
The community have said that they loved the fact that we were there because we weren't full on. You know, we didn't rush down and grab them straight away, put them in the lockup. It was all spoken about first. And then it was decided what action we would take in consultation with the community, really.
One incident at the local school was a classic example of the softly, softly approach.
I just had a phone call from the school principal. She had a young mum go to the school, sort of shouting and swearing and carrying on about something.
Yeah, but you were throwing stones as well at the office and at the school.
The only ones.
Doesn't matter. You can't be doing that.
You need to talk to someone. If you're angry, you need to talk to someone. Right, you give us a call, we'll come and,
give us
and we'll come and talk to you about it. But don't you be running amok, OK?
We can relate to the community and the community can relate to us because we're Indigenous. We have that respect for elders. We have respect for communities. I mean, I've always said that whenever I go to a community, I'm a visitor. Because I'm a visitor, I have to learn the protocols of a community.
Kuran.
Jilpa?
Jilpa.
Wakunu Jilpa.
An early hurdle was the fact that neither Revis nor Wendy spoke the local language.
In language, what is this called?
Yirmanga, Yirmanga.
Yirmanga, Yirmanga.
You will.
I just think that if you can grasp some of the words, it just helps that communication a little bit more.
Dulala!
Dulala, catch the ball! Dulala! Dulala!
You are dulala!
That's a key, communication and engagement.
What would your advice be to police who can feel that disconnect between the Indigenous population and their policing style? What would your advice be?
Introduce yourself to all the kids and, you know, everybody when you're going out on patrols and things like that. About the car. People love it because what it is that they see it. You're actually taking an interest in that community. You're getting out of the car physically and just going and having a chat. Having a catch up. Engage, engage, engage with communities.
No, no. Trouble, Wendy.
After 2 years at Warrakerna, Wendy's been promoted and transferred to Kalgoorlie. She's working on a plan to improve community relations in an area three times the size of Victoria.
We've seen the protests happening around the world in response to what happened in Minnesota with George Floyd. Those protests are happening in Australia now as well. What do you hope will come out of those protests?
Understanding. I'm just hope that it's not going to put up another huge barrier between people. I hope that everybody can get past that and still treat each other properly, you know, in a good way. And that's been always been my motto, is that treat people the way you want to be treated.
When it comes to unifying this country, what would your message be?
We're all humans. You know, cut me, I bleed red. The same as you, Lisa. We're all human. But we've got to bridge that gap and listen to the people, like the local elders and custodians of the country. There needs to be on all sides just listening to each other.
I absolutely love Wendy. That is a story of hope on so many levels, because not only for the police force about connecting and communicating with the communities that they're a part of, but also to think of her story and where she's come from and what she's become, that's really inspiring stuff.
Yeah, she's all about working with the community to solve those problems together. And it is working, which is fantastic. And you can catch the full documentary, Our Law, Monday, the 22nd of June on NITV. Of course, if you can't wait that long, the Sydney Film Festival is running early virtual screenings online from the 10th of June. Just head to the links page on our website to purchase tickets, and I promise you will love it.